This lecture is an introduction to performance measurement. What gets measured gets done. This is an old cliche, but there's a lot of truth to it. Do you care about your grade in this course? Are you studying the exam material a little bit closer than the extracurricular readings? If so, what is getting measured is indeed getting done. But don't get religious about measurement. That's a big mistake. Why? Because many things that are not measured also gets done. And because what gets measured is often not what should be done. For example, I don't really care about your grades, but about what you learn and if you develop an interest and even a passion for production and operations management. Unfortunately, I cannot fully measure that. And although your grade may be a proxy for it, it's not really a perfect measure. Managing performance is an important part of running any professional business. At the very least, companies are very careful in tracking their financial performance, revenue less cost. For managers, measurement helps communicate strategic goals and align the organization in achieving them. It also helps them gain insight about current performance and hence facilitate corrective actions, improvement, and organizational change. Moreover, it can help create a fair distribution scheme for rewards. For employees, having performance measures helps clarify success criteria in their jobs. It can increase motivation to perform and increase self-esteem when performance is good. It also provides them a benchmark for improvement. In short, the use of measurement is an integral part of managing companies. Modern business is unthinkable without performance management, but it is very hard to get it right. In the 1990s, Robert Kaplan and David Norton noticed that companies had a very unbalanced perspective to measures. All companies focused on financial measurements, but far less on other capabilities. As a response, they proposed the balanced scorecard. The balanced scorecard uses four perspectives to encourage a more balanced performance measurement. One perspective is the classic financial perspective. Typical measures here are earnings, revenue, return on investment, manufacturing cost, cost of poor quality, and so on. Another perspective is the customer perspective. Typical measures are customer satisfaction, complaint rates, and market share. A third is an internal business perspective. This is where we measure the direct performance of our operations. We can track process quality, product quality, scrap rates, speed and efficiency, and a range of other metrics. The fourth perspective concerns innovation and learning. Measures that are only indirectly relating to today's operations, but will impact how well we do it in the future. For example, metrics for continuous improvement and skill development belong to this category. The balanced scorecard reminds companies that financial measures are only part of the picture. But even today, many companies would need this reminder time and time again. Here's how I look at it. Financial results is an outcome variable dependent on how we use our assets to meet a demand. How we use our assets? Well, that is a production and operations management topic. Consider a ski jumper. A ski jumper that only focuses on jumping length will not become an Olympic champion. A ski jumper should focus on wind, speed, acceleration, indoor and sitting angle, timing, jump and landing style. And all of these are operational. Or consider a soccer player who is taking the deciding penalty in an important championship final. He or she should better not focus excessively on scoring a goal, but on how to do it. The jump length and goal score is of course what matters in the end and will be measured and reported. But for delivering a good result, a balanced approach to measurement is needed. World-class ski jumper and soccer player also measures the operational metrics during practice. The idea of performance measurement was so compelling to many that Peter Drucker, one of the most influential management thinkers of the last decade, proposed a way to management based almost entirely on it. He called it management by objectives. Today, this strategy is largely debunked, at least as a superior management philosophy. There are plenty of traps in measurement. First, since what gets measured gets done, you risk getting exactly what you measure, not what you want. Second, what is easy to measure is usually not what is right to measure. Third, while measurement may create extrinsic motivation, it can hurt the more effective intrinsic motivation. Fourth, use of performance measurement creates a KPI-driven organizational culture, not necessarily one focused on serving customer needs. Fifth, performance focus creates internal competition, which almost always will be gamed, and create less cooperation and sharing between teams and departments. This is particularly a problem when performance metrics are used for compensation and rewards. Sixth, when measures are not met, people can get low self-esteem, burnouts, and job dissatisfaction. And when measures are always met, people can get complacent. Seventh, performance measurement systems can create costly bureaucracies that drain resources away from delivering performance towards measuring and reporting performance. So what to do? On the one hand, performance measurement is clearly needed, and it can increase performance. But on the other hand, it is impossible to create the perfect measurement system. The key is to be aware of the limitations and use performance measures for decision support. Many companies have created highly effective performance measurement systems that help them develop and maintain a positive performance culture. One such company is, again, Toyota. The so-called Hoshin-Kanri process is an annual policy deployment process that starts with top-level strategies and breaks them down to tangible goals for different departments and teams. This happens in a catch-ball process, where every level communicates goals and measures to the level above and under, almost as if they were throwing a ball down and up the organization. The key here is that each level is creating their own goals to meet the performance challenges set by the levels above. This way of breaking down overall financial measures and operational metrics on the shop floor aligns the whole organization in realizing the set strategies. So, that was a short introduction to performance management. You learned about pros and cons of performance measurement systems, the balanced scorecard, management by objectives, and Hoshin-Kanri policy deployment. What are your performance measures for this year?